absolutely flawless. Hello. Welcome in. Yo. Three in a row. Congratulations to Frog with a Hat. 10 out of 10. Well, 3 out of 3. Perfect. And welcome in Repulsive as well. Yo.
Oh, I stretch.
Oh, TGIF. It is Friday. It is... Even when you're in a part of the world where it's not Friday, trust, it is Friday. It is Friday night, even. So, chef's kiss. How's everyone's week been? How are we? I am chugging my Friday night coffee. Which is, really fucking good, not gonna lie. Yo. It's 1 a.m. Friday. Yes, let's go. It is Friday, everyone now. Welcome in, Sata. What are we listening to? Your beat absolutely running on fumes. Very, very valid. I'm so sorry. I hope you get the weekend off, do you? Huh? I hope so. Because, it has been a long week. I co-sign this. And if you don't get the weekend off, then okay, let me know who I need to throw some fists at. Awaken by Deathclock.
Awaken.
I cannot. Okay, I would not even be able to impersonate that. Wonderful. Yeah, Metalocalypse, I recognize. I totally recognize. What a banger. Huge week, TBH. Congrats all who made it. You co-signing that one, Repulsive. Well done, you made it through as well. Wah. Stretching my neck. I do, but I have to spend it. Spend all the stuff I was supposed to do. Doing the stuff I was supposed to do all week this week. Yeah, I feel that. Last weekend, I spent a big chunk of time, just tidying, just like cleaning up my house. And then Monday rolled around and I was like, oh shit. Where was that relax? I don't know. Kinda sucks when you've got so much on. Either way, I hope you get to sneak some rest in there. Now why is the game not appearing? That's kinda janky. I swear I opened the game. Unless it... Hey! We do have a game. Never fear. We're scuffed, but we're not that scuffed. Starts the game stream. Doesn't play any game. Let's see. English. Yeah, that'd help. For sure. Let's turn down these tunes. So that we can turn up the other tunes. Ayy. We are returning to Valhalla, which has been our Friday night trend for like a couple of weeks now. This game's been very, very good so far. Cyberpunk bartending, action, I think is how they put it. Okay. I will enter the game, but as people trickle in, tell me how your week's been. Tell me your plans for the weekend, especially. I will live through you. I have nothing planned for this weekend. So, quick, give me lives to live through. Day 7. Oh no, even in the games I have bills. That's right, my bill is fucking massive. $8,000 for electricity. What is it the thing in my room? She wants a Daruma? Is this using up electricity? Is that where my electricity bill is coming from? Okay, so... let's check the apps. The augmented eye. Wait, 4chan admin's been arrested. Torrenting too many files? Does that make my electricity bill go up? My camo's making... okay. GSF January 4th card announced. 66 American kid and giant Yusuke headlining. Oh, it's a match. Some kind of boxing match? Okay. Does anyone else wake up and read the news? Because lately I've been kind of going, wow, this is a terrible way to start the day. Like, it was a good habit to be in when it, left me feeling informed. News? However, lately it has left me feeling infuriated, and like that's not an uncommon thing, but lately, more than it used to, and it's a bit of a, I do not wish to not be informed, but I wish to not be angry at the start of every day. News in quotation marks. Hey, look, you're not wrong. There's a lot of, questionable content out there. Nanokamo's now making smart underwear? I wake up and check up on my favorite TikTok cats. Oh, that is so good. Sounds like a much better idea. I agree. That is so much better. Hell yeah. I hope they are going well. If underwear you can change with a voice command was something you really wanted? Like you need to change your underwear for reasons other than aesthetic purposes. Already providing consumer versions of their advanced nanomachine fabric, they plan to release a line of underwear that can change to its look with a spoken word. No more stains in your white panties? Wait, so does it actually change the fabric, or just its look? Oh, just changes color to black and you will barely notice. Ew. Timmy the Chunk is best cat. Oh, that is such a name. I'm googling Timmy the Chunk. Don't know if they will necessarily come up. Hell yeah, they did. Oh, that is a cute baby. Hello, Timmy. Cute, cute, cute. Thank you. Welcome in, Judge Khan. Yo. Are you brown? Upsetting. Prisma, Check, Shrek, Yeti. Are those all cats as well? JK? Oh, Judge Khan! Judge Khan is JK! I get it. I love that they're cats. How goes? It goes alright, thank you. Gonna have a big mouth of water. Because this game involves a hell of a lot of reading. We have been talking a little bit about cats. All right, I will close the Timmy the Chonk tab, which is very good and important. That's kind of cool setup, but yeah, I probably won't read all of that out loud because it's yeah. Not quite on the topic that my brain is on. I was going to say that we, I think I only got midway through this article, talking about smart underwear. Deeply troubling stuff. Deeply, deeply troubling stuff. I have two of those. Cats, I mean, not Dragon Wars. Wonderful. Cats are pretty great. I don't know, my cat has been naughty lately, so... So, she's in my bad books. No! Okay. Is it okay if I eat a bit later, Repulsive? I'm not quite hungry yet. I'm sorry. Or, if you want, I can eat a carrot. Sure. I won't change a smell though, they're not that advanced, that's nasty as hell. Okay. Danger Use admin has been arrested again. December 17 will come. Second retribution. Famous hacker Alice Rabbit graced the popular text bullet Danger U with a new threat, which resulted in the arrest of the site's admin, known as Furfur, for a second time. We have no details to give other than that he was arrested as part of an ongoing investigation. We are now busy tracking down the message that appeared yesterday. When inquired about the arrest, Furfur would only respond with a calm, "Not this shit again." Wait, if he's arrested, why was he surprised? Or not even surprised, just a calm, "Not this shit again" when inquired about it? Odd. That's odd. Famous hacker 4chan, for real. I believe this is meant to be the equivalent of Anonymous. Frankie says hello. Peanut may or may not say hello, I don't know where she is. Give Frankie a pat from me, if Frankie is amenable to such a thing. Some cats are, some cats are not. Poor guy. I've got 5 days to save up 8k. Time to get some tips. Good evening, Jill. Oh, hey guys. How the hell did you get in? I have a copy of the key, remember? Wait, that's how you greet me after so many days? Oh yeah, okay, where we left off, Jill might have been fucking dead. There was that hostage crisis at the bank. And he, like, disappeared as, like, things were getting weird. Frankie will like a scratch from me and I'll say it's from you. Aw, cool. If it were from you directly, there's about a 50% chance of swatting. That's peak cat behavior. Being unpredictable with the swats is extremely valid. Especially with unfamiliar folks. The crystallizing your brain until every genre of storytelling is getting spaghetti. No. No, my brain can't take that. I'm sorry. I work very hard at having a balance in my brain. I will defend it to the end. However, like, a little bit of spaghetti is good. Look, a little bit of spaghetti is good. Only spaghetti. I will have a breakdown. never doubted you'd be fine. If anything, I'd have to cut your paycheck for leaving for so many days without notice. See, Jill, he'll be here on Monday like nothing ever happened. Wait, why does he have a copy of the key and I don't? The need for you to have... for you having a key never arose. True. Anyway, glad you're fine, Jill. Thanks, I guess. What? You gonna make me wash the bathrooms again? Not today. Listen, I don't know who the hell you really are, or what's trying to come back to bite you in the ass. But remember, there are people that actually care about you. Don't just leave like you did. Aww. The spaghetti? Thank you. Thank you for the spaghetti donation, Repulsive. And my mouth is indeed open, ready to catch the spaghetti. Aww. Can leave you all to it, I gotta keep questing work. Oh yeah, no worries. Have a good one, Judge Khan. I hope you have a really nice weekend. Mm-hmm. Huh? Meds reminder. Oh yeah, if anyone's watching and you have meds to be remembering, now is the time. I salute you looking after yourself. Especially after all hell broke loose. At least give us a sign that you're still alive. So you were worried. Isn't that normal? When it comes to you, I don't know. Shut up. She's right though. You shouldn't make ladies worry so much. Check if the cats didn't move the internet. The internet antenna? Wait, is that real? Do I not understand how the internet works? It's a series of tubes. Fine. Hey boss, why did you leave the hoodie in my place? Because it's yours? But I told you you could keep it. Yo, it's V! Welcome, Envy the Crusader. How you going, yo? It is good to see you. Oh! And it's a parson! Thank you for the sippy. Welcome. It is Friday, y'all. I hope your Fridays are going well. And your weekend plans are looking real cool. Or very chill, that's also allowed. I will allow a chill weekend. Wrong Thursday, incorrect. I'm sorry, it's just pre-Friday. You're having pre-Friday. Satellite internet is a thing. True. Okay. But does it have an antenna? Do satellites have a... Wait, is the stick in the middle of a satellite an antenna? Am I understanding satellites for the first time here in 2023? I had to check the clock to see what year it was. Oh no. Glad to see you too, a parson. Yeah, very much so. And not a worry at all. Be late whenever it's, If you want. It's okay with me, is what I'm trying to say. Suspicious that you arrived together. Really? Nah. It was just a perfect excuse. Oh. So it's literally pre-Friday. It's like, Friday Eve. But I told you you could keep it. Wait, I gave my hoodie to my boss? This is a very involved... And this is Yuri as heck, right? Sorry, I... couldn't find it in myself to take it. Why? Probably because I didn't feel right taking it. But mostly because I thought you'd totally look cute with it. I see. Said I'm cute enough. First school dance of the year tomorrow? Wait, school dances happen multiple? Either way, good luck. Have fun? ? An eventful night, so now I'm weak and dizzy. Sorry for intended ambiguous. No worries. You're allowed to be ambiguous. That's totally far enough. I suppose I hope you've got some time for some rest. Give your buddy a good amount of rest in return for the eventful night. Yeah, put your feet up. Agree. Donna's got style would rock that bit. Hell yeah. Don't think I'm rejecting a gift of yours. It's just preserving cuteness is one of my principles. Right. Are you still worried about the whole bar cult closure thing? That's right. Okay. Last time we played, we found out that Dana is definitely way older than we initially had the impression. But as Tumblr taught me earlier today, MILF isn't an age, it's a state of mind. So, it's okay. I can't, oh no. Oh, that's so rude. I'm sorry, cats really enjoy doing that, hey? Work an open house tonight? Gave tours to possible future students. Oh shit, you were repping the joint. How'd you do? Did it go alright? Of course I am. Not like I can't work because of it, but, you know. All we can do is enjoy whatever time we have left here as best we can. Yeah. So, cheer up. Client smells sadness and fear, and we don't want that. I'll go to my office. Okay. Antenna's fine. Did I miss anything? Not really, no. Anyways, let's start the day.
Oh, yes.
Okay. I'm gonna just choose the coolest name. Troubling News. Who was I? Emo? Two? Nighttime Maneuvers. A Star Pierces the Dark. Digital Drive. Yeah, I'll leave the rest. Time to mix drinks and change lives. We're smaller schools, so we need funding. Fair. You know, the late Jimmy Buffett had a song about MILF state of mind? Really? I didn't know that. I only know his, margarita, though. Oh yeah, Joe? Glad to see you're fine. I mean it. Thanks. Oh no, it's the Bitcoin! The parents aren't allowed to talk and share my opinions. The upper classmen in my second tour group and student. I wasn't given time to talk. The goatee is not it. You mean Jill earlier? He's meant to be a bad boy. That goatee is very cyberpunk bad boy. Nasty. I don't know what that means, Sata. Okay, what's this person's voice? You can be a very normal voice, because my throat will hurt. Excuse me, I'm looking for Donald and Zane. May I have your name? Tell her it's Brian. Just a second. Boss, some Brian guy's looking for you. Tell him I'll be there in a bit. Sheila, you heard her. It's alright, I'll wait. It's weird for someone to come asking for her, though. It's not so weird when you're BTC's regional manager in these parts. Oh, right, BTC's the big company that owns us. Right. So I guess crypto really took over the joint. Some of the holocentric makes me put on my face false attorney badge and compulsively cry objection. There are some Ace Attorney-esque moments, aren't there? Like, in the vibe as well as in the soundtrack. Great game series. I enjoyed Ace Attorney. They'll take a razor and... a joke I heard on a UAE gaming show. What? Okay. I see. BTS Corp. Yeah, I guess that's... I guess I didn't give you the best first impression. Don't worry. I know who I'm dealing with. I'm not a fan of people treating me too nicely because of my position anyway. Handle me like I'm just another client. Alright, I can do that. What can I get you, Mr. Brian? Let's go with the basics. Sugar rush, please. Come on right up. Who wants a sugar rush? Music's a little bit loud, isn't it? Let's turn it down a bit. How's the sound level for y'all? It just kinda escalated with this song. Sorry. Damn, Jill's okay. I thought Dana and Jill had some gay thing going on. Oh no, 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 no! There's two Jills. So I'm a girl. She is flirting with me, the girl. I mean, I, Para, am not a girl. Sorry. The character I'm playing in this game is indeed a girl. There is mad Sappho energy between me and my boss. My co-worker also is called Jill, and he's a dude. Why are there two Jills? This guy, copper or copper? What's the difference? Welcome in, Grim of Fade. I love that promo. Oh, thank you. Sorry. I got overexcited, but yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Jill and Jill. Yes. Okay, okay. Dude, Jill is spelled with a G. I believe that they're both pronounced the same way. I swear, I swear. Oh, right. A sugar rush. This is my boss's boss. I probably should not fuck this one up, hey. 2. 1 powder delta. Optional. Let's get him drunk. Next. Sugar rush. Successfully acquired. Oh no! My keyboard's randomly capping and decapping. No! I'm so sorry. I mean... I don't mind. Auto mod might go weird with it, but I doubt. Yeah. Yeah, this one's nice. Back in training, they made a big deal out of sugar rushes. Why? They're like the fried eggs of mixing drinks. Is this song repeating itself? Not a hard G, like the fish breathing organ. My brain did not pass that sentence. Yeah, So there was a dialogue earlier in the game, where I swear someone, like one of the visitors, commented on us having the same name. Mm-hmm. Fried eggs of mixing drinks. They're the most basic thing. People can still mess them up. Sugar rushes are simple enough that you only need to follow instructions. Oh! Okay. Are you going to wield weird power over me? I know a Hachi Jill. You did at some point. The only person I can think of is like BDG, but I think that's Gilbert. Right? Can't even do that. Your future as a bartender is not bright. Huh. They never told me that. You're Jill, right? Yep, that's me. Donna's talked quite a bit about you. Really? I guess you must have a few questions for me, am I right? Is this my new boss? Donna was going to handball me off. Mostly concerning the closure warning Valhalla got. Can you disclose any information? I shouldn't, but you have the right to know. Thanks. Don't mention it. Now where to start? You saw the news on the information leaked during the Apollo Trust Bank incident, right? about the White Knights having lots of members from criminal organizations in their ranks. That's right. Paramilitary, paramedics, military. If they're paramedics and military, that makes them paramilitary, right? Which means that I'm their boss. Turns out the White Knights weren't the only ones with shady people. Para, y'all can join the ranks. No, y'all are paratroopers. Remember I mentioned Sweet Apple Cider? Oh yeah! I think it's a city's... No, making my stomach hurt. Damn. Gotta experiment more. Definitely experiment more. Maybe there's ways of having it in a, like, softer mixed drink or some such. Some of those same folks have been trying to elude legal problems using BTC certified bars. BTC bars have their own protocols, meaning the White Knights can't dig too deeply. At least, not without going through a ton of paperwork first, giving criminals time to cover their tracks. Although it takes a bit of time to set it up, it has apparently proven an effective method for money laundering. You're telling me that I've been facilitating money laundering? Bait? No. Ferocious power, mighty lord of all paramilitary, paramedics, and paratroopers. No, I swear I'm not a benevolent dictator. No, I swear. That's terrible, I hate it. I should never be trusted with power. Just like everyone, really. Where does Valhalla come in? Young girls are the ones under the radar right now, and the modest to low-income ones are the prime suspects. Cozy streamer at evening, shady hidden ruler of the world at night. It's a quick transformation. Malevolent. I said benevolent, but... Hey, look. You can't prove anything. It's not just Valhalla. Any small bar with small income is being investigated heavily right now. So the closure notice is due to low sales. Among the reasons a bar can get axed, low sales is the rarest one. If low sales were a problem, lots of bars would close every year. You'll find out soon enough, huh? Okay. Sorry? Oh, nothing. Don't mind me. Seems your guess was spot on, Jill. If it helps, I'm doing my best to appeal in your place. Really? Why? Most of Glitch City's bars are a pain in the ass. They constantly give reports of chemical damage or shady drinks. This is one of the few places from which I almost never receive complaints. The closest thing to a recent complaint was that whole Pharma Fabrics affair from a little while ago. So much saliva. Ew, what? Wouldn't get my hopes up, though. Especially since the BTC will try to save face by axing as many suspects as possible. Knowing you're making an effort is enough. Thanks. Can I get you anything else? Now that I remember, the recipe book has a drink created here, right? Oh yeah, the suplex. Whoa. I'm gonna give this man a suplex. Get me one of those, please. Sure. Valorant. I've literally never played it before. Why did I think suplex started with B? A small twist on the pile driver, putting more emphasis on the tongue burning and less on the throat burning. Bitter manly. Okay. For Bronson. Me, manly guy. Three karma tree, all on the rocks, and mixed. Yeah. The registry form said this one was an accident while making the pile driver. You can ask the creator of the drink just over there. Ah, so you're Robert. Yes, that's my name. I'm Robert, the one and only. Jill called you Jill. It's Argentinian slang. Robert here is from Argentina, so we call him Chill.
What?
You gonna chill for a bit, V? No worries. Appreciate you stopping in. Do your thing. Wait, what's this song called? It's kind of a bop. Digital Drive, okay. Sorry, Brian. I was sorting some stuff at the office. Please come in. I'll be right there. Any other questions, Joe? Not really, no. Although...
Yeah?
If you were to evaluate my performance right now, how would you rate me?
Oh, no.
Hey chat, if you were to evaluate my performance right now, how would you rate me? Huh? He became so powerful, everything he was afraid of was succumbing to his own power. Which eventually, of course, he never did. Yay!
Yay!
Fortunate. He taught his apprentices everything he knew about social work, then his apprentices saved him from his night duties and granted him sleep. Ironic. He could save others from struggles, but got saved himself? No, that's perfect. I would like that. That sounds wonderful. No, Opossum, you're so funny.
Puppy pastas are delightful.
9.4. That is outstanding. Very silly and calming. Well, hell yeah. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Clean and timely delivery of the correct orders. Top-notch bartender.
Thanks.
Now if you'll excuse me. I'm surprised you haven't met him before.
I received my training in another city. The regional supervisor there was some girl with a red mohawk.
Oh, I see.
I wonder what boss will talk to Brian about. Chill, was it?
Yes! Yes! My queen!
Okay, need to sit up straight for Miss Stella.
Like, nothing weird, just like, I don't know, this is a general, right? Like, this is someone that is, like, leading me into battle, right?
Catgirl, indeed. It's the servo eye that has me going, ooh. Miss Stella, what a pleasure.
You okay?
Yeah, just call me... Wait, what's your voice?
What is your voice?
Just call me Stella and get me a big beer, please.
Sure, honey.
A big beer. Great big bushy beer.
He's trying to put Bush in the beer.
Find enough war crimes around these parts.
That was not meant to be so political. I meant it as a George Bush joke.
All mixed.
Success.
Tomorrow is my first school dance. Over the weekend I have a MUN! Oh my god, you've thrown me back. I used to teach people how to MUN.
Oh no, I've revealed very personal information. Oh no, oh no.
Long ass 3 days. It does sound like some frickin' packed time. I hope that it all goes really well. Are you like dressing up for the dance and everything too?
Are you sure you're fine?
You know Say, right?
Of course, what's up with her?
She was at the Apollo Trust Bank during that whole affair, and...
Oh, right, then.
So she... She didn't show up on the list of the massive body count in the aftermath, so... I was hoping that maybe you've seen her. Wait, was Zayn one of the anarchists? No way! That unassuming girl? Wait... They still play the classics at school dances.
Green Day's Time of Your Life. Probably not. Disappointing.
A bit special, but not too much. That's still nice. Hell yeah, special occasion. As much as I'd love to say that I had... Yeah, I figured as much. Man, the air is suddenly a lot heavier. Was that the black hat hacker girl? No, it was the, really unassuming girl.
Let me know in 11 minutes if you could.
Yo, I will try, but I will forget. Like, just letting you know. I will try. I mean, I could tell her everything will be alright, but that would sound a bit condescending. What does one do in this kind of situation? You assist that person with what is within their control. You find things that are within their control. That's just my humble opinion, not a professional, objective opinion. Good. Writing that a planner. My drugs are digital? Digital drug? Maybe a jerk? No, that'd be tasteless. Okay, just try and say anything. At the very least, you'll break the tension. Maybe distracting her will be enough. I don't think clearly when under this kind of pressure, do I? There's a private eye here the other day.
Eye? No!
Sorry, I'm a bit on edge. Private detective, I take it. Yeah, maybe you'll want his services? What's his name? I believe it was Art Van... No, Vandalay. Oh, that Art guy. Yeah, I actually hired him yesterday to look for Say. So you still have proof? I'm somewhere between bargaining and depression right now. And I'm afraid to let go of bargaining. I see. Is he any good? He doesn't look like it, but he's quite skilled at gathering intel. I believe he'll give me answers about Say, whatever they might be. Sometimes I wish I had a magic wand so I could solve all of my problems with a swing, you know. Sorry if I'm making you uncomfortable. Oh, sorry, no. It's not about feeling uncomfortable. It's just weird. I usually try to say something to my clients when I sit them down. And right now I can't find any words that don't sound hypocritical, useless, or tasteless. I'm glad to know you have that much common sense, at least. All I can do is get you drinks. Can I get you anything else? Something sweet. That'll help me calm down a bit. Gladly. Okay. Flavor. Sweet. Moonblast? Kind of a banger, but it does keep feeling like the music's going way too loud, so chat, you would tell me if it was way too loud, right? 6 o'clock. One kind of darker, one kind of guy, two country. It's fine, good. On the rocks and blooming wave. Just speak louder? I'm sorry. I had pushed my chair back. Here. Thanks. Seems you really like Say. I don't have brothers or sisters, and my social interactions are usually strictly business. So Say is more than a friend to me. She is. Your girlfriend? Sorry, I brought that topic up at a bad time. Don't worry about it. As I was saying, she's more than a friend. She's my emotional support. She's someone I can trust wholeheartedly. I'd say she's like my sister, but siblings usually lack that level of trust. I have to deal with high-class pricks of every race and upbringing on a daily basis. I've forgotten what she does. What are you? Are you catgirl mercenary? They use a business mask to hide anything they don't want others to know, and I do the same. But with Say, I can be myself. I can do whatever I want and vent all my frustrations. Yes, Say does seem like... She's always been there for me. And now she might need me. But here I am, sitting in a bar, making other people do that job, because I'm a useless pile of flesh. Sorry about the outburst. I'm actually kind of jealous of the level of self-control you're using here. I mean, I'd be a mess in that situation. Still, would you like some fresh air? I'm gonna take my break and you could use some. Well, forgiven value of fresh. I'm fine, thanks. Okay then. Jill, please service Miss Stella while I take my break. Sure, leave it to me. It is break time already. That one? I know what I'm doing. God damn, is it chilly outside? Okay. I forgot to check to see if I had accidentally put the same song on multiple times, so my apologies. Every day is night. Synthestitch? That's a cute name for a song. Dawn approaches, and she looks good. Dusk. Follow the trail. Okay. Ready. I'm back. Huh? What would a kid like you know about that, eh? I'm just giving you the facts as they are. What happened while I was gone? Let's see. Detective guy comes in. Cat boomer girl. Cat boomer? What's a boomer? Greets him. They start talking. Everything was okay until the girl mentioned Zaibatsu Corp offhand. After that, the guy got riled up and started bad-mouthing it. Oddly enough, he was the only one. She just carried on like it was just a normal conversation. I see. Well, I won't deny Zaibatsu Corp is anything but innocent. When you get down to it, it has enhanced the quality of life here. Oh, you're a corporate apologist. Is she in, like, business? She mentioned people putting on a business face.
Yeah, if by enhanced, you mean getting yanked around by a shiny new chain around our necks. Can't you see that those big companies don't care about us? Why do you think Glitch City is mockingly called the guinea pig of the world? We're just one big test group for them to use however they want. But then again, I don't expect a kid to understand how hard it was, let alone a rich kid.
True, I don't know. And true, I have a privilege that clouds my judgment. But can you deny that the meddling of Zaibatsu Corp has brought quite a few benefits?
Like what?
The AI integration program they started is making huge advances in the AI department. Every day, more and more countries are seeing the benefits of recognizing AIs as citizens.
Yes, but we also hold the AI Reformation Program. meaning that we're also the world's Lilith prison. AI went rogue, transfer it to a delivery drone or ship it to Glitch City. That murderer is now delivering your pizza.
What? Think Saibatsu is a cop in GTA? Huh. Fair point. Although that program has proven to have reformed many AIs. They don't brag about their 88% success rate for nothing. The city also has a stronger economy. Saibatsu Corp's success has made more and more companies bring their products here.
And the gap between classes continues to grow. More companies just mean more people who will plant their feet on your face.
But it also means more products are being brought to the lower classes. Stores have 20% more brand variety compared to last year.
I thought she was cool. This is sad.
I like old school GTA. I didn't really play any GTA growing up, sorry.
Or is it the kind of game that would be entertaining even without nostalgia?
Saibatsu Corp's main medical research branch has also made lots of discoveries. More and more illnesses previously thought incurable are being addressed every day.
It's amazing, for those who can afford them. Meanwhile, down here we're experiencing medicine shortages almost every month.
You have a point there. Oh, but there are also more jobs. All of the companies coming down here need personnel. So the unemployment rate has gone down by almost 40% this year.
More jobs? Shut up.
Am I wrong?
Well, that's... Hey, you, don't just sit there. Give me a Zen Star.
Sure. The sore baby? Alright. Sour promo bland. You'd think something so balanced would actually taste nice. You'd be dead wrong. Four of each ingredient. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Declaring a thumb war. On ice and mixed. Think it was pretty original for its time? Hell yeah.
I mean, it was obviously very popular for a reason.
Yeah.
God, this is awful.
It's your order, though.
I seriously hope you don't really believe everything you just said.
Of course I do. Why else would I say it? You do bring up something I always fail to remember. All of the benefits we've gained over time are limited to a few. I can talk about advances all I want. But in the end, there's still a luxury belonging only to a few. And even those that can be accessed by everyone are more like an improvement in the bigger picture. That doesn't take away the fact that there have been positive changes. Credit where credit's due, don't you think?
That's a pretty mature answer.
Is it? Discussions are a way for two parties to understand each other. The only people afraid of discussion are the ones whose points are too fragile to defend against someone.
I don't think that's how that works at all. Okay, debate bro. I don't think that's how that works at all. Yeah, absolute debate lord behavior. Someone can be afraid of discussion for more reasons than having a weak argument under their belt. Like...
Yeah, mature, whatever. Gonna take the chance to ask you about that job I gave you yesterday.
I haven't been able to find much, but I can at least tell you that she wasn't at the bank when it opened up.
What does that mean?
Either she left before the whole ordeal started, or she managed to escape at some point before the whole thing ended. Destroyed by facts and logic, truly. All the corpses are accounted for. They only found one totally disfigured, but witnesses identified it.
It wasn't your friend, that much is for sure.
I see.
Did you call him here?
No, he just so happened to come here today.
The weird part is that the girl did enter the bank. It's like she vanished or something.
I see. Thanks. Keep it up.
Your face brightened a bit.
Hope is the last thing you lose, I guess. If he's telling the truth, Sing might have found a way out. She's a resourceful girl. She surely did something. I think I'll have another drink. You want anything?
Me? Oh. Just give me whatever you want.
Two bad touches, please.
On it. Two bad touches. Two Bronson Extract, two Powder Delta, two Planner Guide, four Coming Train. Box and mixed. Two, four. Box mixed.
I remember this one party I went to. The guy that came up with the name of this drink showed up. After people found that one out, they lined up to slap him for whatever reason. They didn't seem offended to me, though.
Imagine a guy shows up and tells you, I made a classy bad touch. Wouldn't you line up to slap him?
Are you okay, Jill?
I'm fine. Now that I think of it, did you find that girl you were looking for a week ago, Mr. Von Delay? Turns out she was at the Apollo Trust Bank all this time. No wonder I couldn't get in touch with her.
Gal?
Someone paid me to look for Crimson Rose. She happened to me at the...
What?
I'm trying to avoid mentioning that a dangerous assassin got stuck in the same bank as the girl you're looking for.
Oh, don't worry. Besides, the last thing I'm worried about with Say is people.
Why's that?
Her attitude is usually so laid back and gentle, she has no problem getting people on her side. And the off chance that she has to defend herself, well... I once saw her take care of a warbot gone haywire by herself. She did need medical help afterwards, but she recovered in no time and managed to take care of the bot. She really that good? She's not only really physically fit, she's also really good with Krav Maga and...
Something wrong?
No, nothing. I just realized I forgot all about that. Say it's not invincible, but she knows how to take care of herself. And like I said, she's resourceful. She surely found a way out. I just hope she's well, whatever the hell she is, wherever the hell she is. She owes me an ice cream. You want another drink, Mr. Von Delay? It's on me.
Are you sure?
Yeah, order away.
Okay, I'll have a piano man.
And you, Miss Stella? I'm fine, get his order. Piano man. Two Adelheid. Three Bronson Extract, 5 Powder Delta. Five Flanagan, 2, 4, 5. 3 Karma Train on the box and next. Yeah.
So this is what drinking something classy without worrying about the price feels like. All right. How should get going? My contact will arrive at the rendezvous point soon. I'll let you know if I find out anything else, Miss Hoshi.
Please do.
Right then. Be generous today.
He made my night with his discoveries on Say's situation. I'm not totally over it, but at least I got distracted for a bit. I think I've had enough for today. How are you feeling? Better than when I came in at the very least. Thank you for everything.
Please come again.
Phew, it's been quite the day.
At least the streets are calm today. I have arrived yet again at the Majestic Hall of Heroes. I was so close to naming my stream title Majestic Hall of Heroes. I was so close. And then I was like, is that too dorky? The answer is yes, it's very, very, very dorky. But like, maybe it would have been good dorky, you know? I'm gonna mute for a second while I grab some carrots. Lunch today, so my dinner right now is carrot and tzatziki. I will eat more later, to be clear. This is just a snack dinner. The crunching noises are terrible. Who is coughing and wheezing at me? Calm until now. We meet again, bartender. Wait, what was your voice? This person was like gender ambiguous. Like very flamboyant. Maybe every voice I do is a little bit gender ambiguous. Okay. You look winded, Virgilio. Virgilio? It's pronounced Virgilio. Oh. Virgilio? Huh? Virgilio. No, I'm pretty sure it's Virgilio. You said as much the last time you came. Pronunciations are a silly thing society imposes on the letters. So true. Pronunciation is indeed a social construct, unironically, but they want to be free. They want to be pronounced however they want. You look winded, Virgilio. We are all little toys, winded by the cruel hand of fate. Just stumbling until it decides not to wind us anymore. Or wind it. And yet, you're the only one in the vicinity hyperventilating. That's, I was jogging. Dressed like that? I can jog however I want. Yes, you can. What can I get you? Something fake. Of course. Something fake? Huh? Okay, let's go from the top. Teeth turn blue. Oh, as soon as I finish eating, you give me more food? That's so rude. Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry, is the munching really loud? You like the munch ASMR? That's really funny. I was reading a bunch on somatic therapy techniques and started realizing that ASMR is like, it's there. Perfect volume? Interesting.
One of these just says fake on it, you know? I didn't find anything, damn it. Bottled drinks? Iced tea. All of it's fake. Oh my god, gimme... Is this fake? They used to actually... Okay. Sparkle Star. They used to actually sparkle, but too many complaints about skin problems made them redesign the drink without the sparkling. So it's not actually sparkling. Does that make it fake? That's the closest I'm getting. Okay, Sparkle Star. This one's pretty close to the real deal. This seems like fake beer then, right? Maybe. Okay, I'm gonna go with beer. Two, three, four. Here you go. Now, tell me why this is fake. Because I didn't even try. Your expectations of me giving a damn about the abstract order of fake. God damn it, I didn't get it right. Bravo, brilliant. Or is that literally the always? Okay. Say, Virgilio, where do you work? I take the noble duties of curator at the Steampunk Museum. Where is your top hat? Really? What do you do? I study everything that comes and keep it clean for the people that visit the premises. But lately my duties are being hindered by the museum's... Really? Yeah, he told me, stop touching the exhibits, you're gonna break them. The nerve of some people. Eh? He still fails to realize that I'm the curator, though. Without me, all those machines would be rustier than they already are. Even the visitors get that I'm the one responsible for those. Why can't the owner realize that too? Yeah. I bet he treats you like a janitor or something like that. Exactly. Okay then. Time for your next challenge, bartender. Challenge, she says. Morning. Welcome in, Wand Herring. I have truly missed on the hour. Someone requested earlier, V requested earlier. For me to say something on the hour. I failed that miserably. How are you going, Wand Herring? Happy Friday. I want purity. He wants purity? Ew. Weird. Can't give him pure ingredients. There's always another hour. So true. Okay. Purity. Mm. This, like, drink request has me in a whirl. I honestly don't know. Oh, my coffee. Mm. Wonderful. A sugar rush? Sweet, girly, happy. Is that what they mean by purity? Frothy water? Mmm, don't you like frothy water? Mmm, yum yum yum. What's the flavors here? Bubbly? Time. Your spiced tea? Your fluffy dream. Frothy water and absinthe. Actually, you know what? I might try frothy water. One of each of those. Aged and mixed. How is this pure? It's a drink. It's free from any human sin. It can do no harm consciously. Ah, yes. Beautiful. Okay, wonderful. Oh, excuse me as I, stumble. Hey, you, the guy over there. It worked. It did work. Thank you very much for your help. Me? Yes, you. Have we met before? Can't remember. Maybe. Yes, I think. No. We haven't met ever at all. That's an interesting reaction. Yes, Donna. Your sister is certainly cute. Can I leave, please?
Fine. We discussed what we had to anyway. Careful out there.
Thank God. Pleasure meeting you, gentlemen. Same to you, Robert. Please come again. Bartender, you're done oogling Mr. Holocaust. Would you mind giving me a drink? Another? What do you want? I want to leave. Bye, bartender. That'd be $500. Second time you run off like that. He's either hiding here or would rather not be found by the police. What do you think, Jill? I know nothing of it. Of course you don't.
Are we done for the day?
Yep. Quite a few clients considering the whole situation. Oh shit! The Virgilio guy. So you two actually met before? Yeah, you could say that. What? Jill stuff. Don't mind it. What were you talking about to Brian?
Well, we were mostly catching up, to be honest. I hadn't seen him in a while. I offered him a drink when we met last week.
Wish I was pure and free from human sins as well.
I believe in you. Repent. Repent to Para.
We'll make a channel redeem for repenting your sins. No, that's fucking terrible. I hate that.
Enjoy your sins, chat. You have my full tacit endorsement.
I haven't seen him. I offered him a drink when we met last week. I talked a bit about what we do after the bar closes. Oh, and I tried to, explain the situation with Robert. He agreed to help me out with that one when the time comes.
Oh.
Oh. I was also tuning up the details for the new employee.
New employee?
Part-timer. You'll meet him tomorrow.
Oh. Him. So it's a guy.
An adorable guy, if I do say so myself. Mm-hmm.
I suddenly have deja vu. Are you alright, Jill?
Yeah. Must be nothing.
Ooh. Damn, we made 2.5 grand?
Nice, nice, nice. Okay, I really need to hold on to money. I need to save up for my bills. Sad, it's just like real life. What is Kiramiki up to? Dream person. Every now and then, I wonder if I'll ever meet my significant other. All the stimuli from being born just 3 years ago, being directly thrown in this wonderful disaster that is the idol industry, makes me think of all the things I'm missing. Accidental love, lost love, or even the gentle touch of another person. I feel like I'm in this bubble that won't let me catch all possible feelings. My senses get tired of the same environment. I want to meet new people, places, because even though I have a large bank of knowledge, I actually never experimented with what most consider normal. But you already know that from my songs. Damn. Kiramiki is beginning to rattle the bars of her cage. Should I consider being a celebrity a cage? Being a robot thrust into celebrity-dom while having artificial intelligence. Yeah, that's most certainly a form of cage. When I say human, I hear Dracula voice lines from Castlevania. Wonderful. I feel myself in a morally yet decadent aristocratic creature. Beautiful. Perfect. I watched the first season, I think, of the anime adaptation. The one on Netflix, I want to say. That was pretty good. Wait, was that Castlevania? Now I'm second-guessing myself. Alright, let's read the... Let's save. I don't know if I already saved. No, I didn't. Well. Let's read this. Nano camo underwear? Polar Bank is getting attacked. Okay, I don't think I've read this before. I may have last streamed, but either way, let's refresh. Polar Bank is being attacked, thread 3. Explosion registered. And media is still quiet about it. Can confirm there's an explosion. But it looks like it was just one of them. So there's more bombs, not just one? That's right. Do you have any clue on who's doing this? I'm hearing from several sources that this is a group, a new one, looking to overthrow the government. No names have been mentioned, and it looks like it's not a group, but just one person who set up all of this. Huh? Actually, they do keep, in this forum, they keep kind of fluctuating between whether Alice Rabbit is a group of people or a single hacker. So that this, the terrorist attack, what are they calling it? Yeah, the attack on the bank, is being coordinated by an unknown single lone wolf slash coordinated group. And the ambiguity in the storytelling here. I haven't watched it, but I heard it's a decent one. I was meaning old Castlevania games. Yeah, absolutely. Castlevania games, absolute classics. I have not played them in many, many, many years. I think you just reminded me of the TV series, which is probably the most recent piece of media. I think of. Standalone Complex, yes. I think they refer to it more as a, like, lone wolf, or, like, a lone actor. What's the word? There's a word for it in, like, wary... Yes. I don't know how to pronounce that. Stochastic? But that's what I was thinking of, yeah. having a bit of ambiguity between whether it is coordinated or whether it is a single actor, is good story writing. Like, it's good piece of the puzzle to leave as ambiguous, and as we're like in the height of this crisis situation, we're yet to learn, right? Excuse me while I eat more. And this is just a rumor around here, but Alice Rabbit might be involved. A hacker is helping out hostages to escape, and they're suspecting of Alice. Someone doing stupid shit on the internet is being actually useful. Wait, the hacker is helping out hostages to escape. That's interesting. Thought they were going to imply that Alice Rabbit was involved with the attack itself. Bon appetit, thank you. I mean, I don't often eat carrot sticks and dip or anything, so this is like... I just really wanted vegetables lately. Okay. And confirm the situation has finally reached its end. The attacker was shot dead, but a huge amount of data. Okay, so we've at least confirmed that attacker in this bank crisis situation was definitely not that one paramedic lady. I was wondering if it was going to be a plot twist like that. A huge amount of data was released from servers all around the world. Remember the leaks from Alice? Those were nothing compared to this. Proof of corruption, money laundering, espionage. It's actually pretty unsettling. The file is available from approximately 60,000 sources. Terabytes that contain all operations from the Glitch City government and White Knight operations. It seems the ultimate goal from the attacker was not to blow up the bank, but lead hostages towards the servers inside the bank, which had the files under several layers of physical security. Oh, so it was a hack job. That shit sounds whack. How do you even make a plan this complex? That doesn't seem like that complex a plan. There are files under intense security, and then they use the cover of hostages. Anyway, I'm gonna... No idea. That's what some of the witnesses are telling the police. Okay, it looks like I have to leave, but I'll try to write down all the details for a future post. I'm gonna need some time, though. Godspeed and on, thanks. Nano camo. Underwear. Oh, okay. Tad, useless unless you're a streaker or have a boyfriend. Wait, did I miss messages? Some deep shit happened right there. I have not noticed. Do you read the file? Nah. I talk to my cat about what I'm reading. That is cute. I think I'll get a pair, just to see what kind of skin I can use with them. They will nickel and dime the DLC. There's no way to use the skin you want. Could get cracked day one. Maybe, but I don't think it will be that fast. I think I'll just wait until it's modded for custom skins. I thought the nanomachine fabric was bad for your health. No, that's just a meme. My walls are made of that thing and I'm alright. Are the walls hacked yet? I'm going to marry Camotown. Oh right, okay. We now have underwear that can change its look. Don't we just love the future? I would if they weren't such a bunch of assholes with their business practices. Then don't buy the underwear. I won't.
Okay. Nano. Yeah, Nano Kammer. Hello. Kawaii desu. Did a new article come out? No, I just haven't read these. The EKDF 186 get a historic update. Pretty good at writing realistic social media threads. I agree. Like, especially the level of uncertainty. And also the range of taking it very seriously to taking nothing seriously at all. Weapon enthusiasts are freaking out right now over a firmware update that Makise Heavy Industries is releasing for its EKDF 186 line of assault rifles. Full compatibility with nano camo has been announced, allowing civilian models of this weapon the use of nano camouflage and the option to customize their look for free with the help of the NanoCam app. We've been using nano camo on the battlefield for a year now, the chairperson. Thanks to flexibility, we can now sneak past the enemies. Our equipment is basically invisible with nano camo. That sounds safe and healthy. And like something I definitely want as a member of the public. Didn't you play a game from these guys? Wants to go puzzle, yeah. New waifu machine. Tsukuban Soft just unveiled a new line of personal computers for the anime enthusiast market. Okay. Men prefer Christmas cakes, study reveals. What? For the longest time, the term Christmas cake referred to women aged 26 or above, who are regarded as undesirable. Speak for yourself. sure, buddy. It's like a Christmas cake that ceases being useful after December 25th. That's sad. Who doesn't like a mature woman? Todd, 19. Jill, 27, is confused. After discovering the real meaning, she launched into an hour-long rant. I'll let you know, pencil skirts are the best. Okay. The writers, had fun with that one, I guess. I think I need to, who doesn't like some Christmas cake up to a week? Oh, yeah, absolutely. After, like, a week after Christmas, I'm pretty sure I have still been eating Christmas cake, yeah, up to New Year's for sure. Especially if it gets marked down. Not to, like, reveal my, like, poorness, but I'm buying the markdown Christmas cake. not that, like, this is obviously not a comparison to older women. And, like, 26 being old is so, so wacky. Anyone over 26, you have got many decades of life ahead of you. And, I think that there is no age at which you are market compatible. Hopefully you meet people throughout your life that are greatly compatible with you. I think it's time to work. Good evening. Oh, hello, Jill. Ooh, I don't think I changed the channel. Passy Zero. Huh? Ooh. Wait, is that a new channel? You know what? I'm putting on the blank screen channel. In that cage, I brought my cat. Your cat?
Did I hear Yasunori Kato was in the bar? Bring that bastard. I'll give him a fist of justice. I'll make him eat the Kanto earthquake. I'll borrow his cap.
Wait, there are no evil Onyuri? Onyuri?
Boss, what the fuck? Didn't you say you brought Kato to the bar?
My cat?
Cat? Well, that's even better. Hey, Four.
So cute. Why did you bring him?
I heard some apartments in my building were being raided. I don't have anything suspicious, but you never know. So I'd rather have him here at least today.
Oh well, I'd say something about the health regulations, but we already had a pack of corgis here. You want me to take care of him in my office? Please?
Sure. He's a bit shy, so...
Alright, Four, let's go to my office.
I think she didn't hear me. Say, Jill, how do you always come so early?
I live close by.
Really?
Yep. Chief got me a small apartment nearby. Something about the BTC housing program.
Oh yeah, I got mine through that too.
Anyway, let's start. Wait, we both got our housing through our workplace?
Okay.
I keep clicking on digital drive. Skyline? Assignment. Underground. Tents. City. I don't think that has any repetition. Oh. Time to mix drinks and change lives.
Yo, what's up?
Hell yeah, I was waiting to serve another corgi.
Lady, you hear me?
Exactly, thank you. A dog. Another dog.
Hey, I'm not just another dog. Came here as a part-timer.
I'm not serving the corgi. The corgi is serving the public. This papa. So you're the part-timer?
Yeah.
Boss, I'm taking my break.
It's too early.
Shit. The part-timer's here.
Huh, he came early.
Why a dog? Why?
Cause look at him. He has a Hawaiian shirt and sunglasses. And he's a Shiba, not a corgi. I don't know what you're complaining about.
I knew that. I don't know why I mixed up the two. They all look racist. That's horrible.
SMH, Jill.
Very disappointing. Speciesist behavior. Shibas could be seen as the Japanese counterpart to Corgi.
They're both funny looking, and dogs used to be them. And dogs used by the royalty. Anyway, starting today, this dog will help around here.
My name.
It doesn't matter what your name.
No, fuck you, Donna. Boss, please don't shout.
Sorry. Just call him Rad Shiba.
What? Why Rad Shiba? That seems very belittling.
What part of Hawaiian shirt and sunglasses don't you get?
He's the raddest thing here. Thanks. Anyway, he'll mostly help getting orders, bringing clients in, and cleaning. But he ought to know how things work.
Cleaning? That'd be a change of pace.
He'll act like a client and see how you work.
Right.
What can I get you?
I'll have a grizzly temple. Are you okay?
Yeah, just a couple of post-traumatic flashbacks. Coming right up. Grizzly temple. Re-Adelheid. Re-Bronson extract. Re-Power Delta. One comma tree. Blender. Here. Wow, this is awful. People actually pay for this shit?
Hard to believe, I know. So, what brings a dog like you to take a part-time job here?
I'm here to help the funding of my organization.
You with the Safer Toy Company?
One sec. I think I need a new chair. I think I will, think about that when I'm off the air. I need to write that down because I keep forgetting to look into things. Okay.
What? No, don't let me in with those herding supremacists.
Ooh. I have a more noble and benign organization. I belong to CIRA.
CIRA?
Canine Independent Rescue Association. Oh, we give a place where dogs can be dogs and save them from themselves. CIRA is what I love, but damn, it is expensive sometimes. We decided to take part-time jobs to help fund anything it needs. We want to help CIRA be the best it can be.
What do you do at CIRA?
Pay treatment for hurt dogs, give food to the hungry ones, play with the bored ones. We're there for everyone.
Huh, that actually sounds nice.
Say, you have a menu?
Something like that, yeah. Yeah.
Now, let's see. Any recommendations?
Avoid the part with promo drinks.
Oh, Grizzly Temple is one of those. Fluffy Dream? I like the sound of this one.
Coming right up.
The doggo wants a fluffy dream.
Good.
Free Adelheid. Free Powder Delta.
Optional Karma Train. Do I want to give the dog some more alcohol?
I'll give him one.
Fluffy Dream.
Well, this one's nice.
So, why'd you pick a bar?
Seemed fun. I didn't need that many weird skills to be part of this, so it was my best bet.
Aww. That's precious repulsive, I love it.
Besides, it's close to home, so I can get here walking.
Aww, dog comes for a walk to go to work.
And I do love me some walks. I could walk all day.
Weird skills?
Yeah, stuff like food handler certificate, previous work experience, thumbs. Why did you pick a bar?
On a whim too, I guess. Wanted a place where I could see people come and go all the time. And bartending sounded a bit more glamorous than just being a store clerk.
Oh yeah, about the way you mix stuff.
Yeah?
Is it... Cat! Cat!
A4? Weren't you in boss's office?
Hello, cat. Wanna play? Let's play.
Didn't dogs hate cats or something?
We don't hate them. Unless they're intruders.
Huh.
You said his name was 4? Hello, 4. Let's play.
No playing allowed. You'll make a mess. Or go back to boss's office.
Yeah.
That's one obedient cat. My pride. You want something else? Yeah, but I'll talk with John Face here for a bit. Huh? Alright. I shouldn't get riled up so easily by dogs, but I'm just tired, I guess. Hello, Jill. Huh? The voice. Her! That's the one. That's the one that's missing. That cat ear red liberal is looking for. Eh? What happened to you? Nice seeing you too. Well, I fell from a really tall place to a really rough spot. You okay? You need an ambulance or something? I just got out of one. Don't worry. You just got out of the ambulance? How did you manage to slip by all the mobs lynching white knights? It was a bit rough. Luckily, these bandages helped me conceal my identity. Why come straight here? The ambulance where I got treatment couldn't stray too far from the hospital. They're nice people. I've talked to them a lot while on rescue duties. I was nearby, and yours was the closest friendly face I could find. I needed to regain my composure before doing anything else, so hurry up. If you're scared because they might come for me, I can leave, you know? The security system and the bar are top-notch, and the boss is also the bouncer of sorts here. I'd say you're actually safer here, so I'm not worried about me. Instead, I'm worried about you. First I hear you're at the bank, then I find out you disappeared. And now you show up with all those bandages. Are you fine? What happened at the bank exactly? Did you talk with Stella? She was worried sick about you. Slow down a bit. The medications make me feel everything more intensely. Almost like a hangover. Sorry. Oh, good night, Sata. Thanks for dropping in. It's nice to know someone like a bartender was worried about me, though. Thanks. Everyone I know has been ignoring me, so I was feeling lonely. Why would they? Well, you've seen the lynches they give to any white knight they can find. By ignoring me, they're actually saving me from getting kicked to death. My good deeds finally paid off, I guess. Can I get you anything? Something sweet without alcohol. Thank God these pants still have my wallet in them. Oh no, I couldn't take your money right now. So no. Jill, please. I want to pay for my drinks. I take it I won't be able to change your mind? I mean, you won't be able to change my mind. Sweet and no alcohol, right? Coming right up. Aged and mixed. Careful. Yay. This'll help me calm down a bit. So, what happened to you? Where did you fall from? I was escaping the place near the end of the whole thing. I had to make a leap of faith. So I jumped from higher places, but I landed badly here. Most of my injuries are actually from some debris that fell on me. Oh, but my broken arm is actually from the fall. Huh? I rolled to mitigate the fall, but I made a bad move and broke it. Good thing I drink lots of milk. I was under rubble for quite a bit, but luckily someone found me. Someone? They woke up in the hospital. They told me some guy brought me that. I don't know who he was, but I owe him my life.
You reckon?
What?
Nothing, you just sound cheerful.
I'm alive. Why wouldn't I be? After all that happened at the bank, here I am talking to you. Being able to talk at all. Don't think too much about it.
Oh no, I need a drink. That is the last of my water.
I'm fine. I'm totally f- Ow, ow, ow. How are things around here? I heard there was a huge commotion when the whole thing happened.
I had to sleep here in the bar on Saturday. Guess it could have been worse.
Glad to know that.
Did you contact Stella? She was on the verge of despair yesterday.
Hey, chill. I want another drink. A Bleeding Jane.
She asked for a Bleeding Jane. Is it her best idea to give her one? What's in a Bleeding Jane? It doesn't have any commentary. The game is trying to prompt me to not, and I'm tempted to not, don't get me wrong, I'm genuinely tempted to not. However, you know? Yeah, I'll give her something else. Yeah.
Good. Thanks.
Yeah. So, all things inside the bank.
Come again?
What happened inside the bank? How did you manage to get through it?
I was with this nice bunch of people. Well, they were apparently nice, at the very least. We tried our best to find a way out of the whole thing. Cracking through the security, finding safe spots.
Sorry for asking all that. It was obviously over the line.
No, don't worry about it. It's just the analgesics still numbing me. I'll take my leave now. Thank you for everything, Jill.
You alright?
I'm fine.
Huh? Weren't you leaving?
Yeah, I was, but... You know how I just said I was fine?
Yeah.
I'm not. So I wanted to know if you could lend me your ear.
Well, I was gonna take my break.
Oh, sorry.
No, what I mean is, I could lend you an ear if you don't mind going to the back alley for a bit.
Yeah, please.
Okay. Want one? Deep breaths, chat behind the bar with a bandaged girl. An achievement indeed.
Sorry, I haven't smoked since high school. But don't mind me though, smoke ahead.
Thanks. So, why me?
You're the closest friend I have nearby that isn't avoiding me, and I think I'm about to explode.
Why?
Because I'm afraid. I'm terrified.
Good on them for recognizing they were not okay. I agree, Wandering. I agree so much.
And hey, Poppy. Welcome in, you. Welcome to Friday. I'm gonna take a second. Chomp on carrot. I'm wondering if not giving them alcohol open this dialogue option? I don't know. Oh. Taking the time to, like, talk through it. See, I thought that maybe she was holding back, like, I thought maybe she was giving the impression of holding back, because she was actually in deeper on the, not the good guy's side, quote unquote. Oh, thank you for kindness, you. Appreciate it a lot. So I'm kind of glad that she's letting it out. And kindness to chat, hell yeah. I hope everyone's going well, by the way. Hope you're going alright, Poppy. I'm terrified, I'm scared. My colonel was using me when I made that errand. He saw me as a disposable pawn. Aww. Then the whole thing got closed at the bank. We were stuck there with no food or water for 3 days. I saw a man be- Oh, Jesus. After he found some snack in his pocket. That. You're fine but sleepy as hell. It is rest day, right? I hope it is rest day. When I was in the rescue duties, usually dealt with collapsing buildings, fire, that kind of stuff. But seeing people do that to other people is just... Calm down. Nobody will hurt you here. You sure? I'm not, but it's a long story. Follow me on Twitter. Yeah, I do. I follow you on Twitter. The reason's there. No worries. It's not rude at all. It's totally fair enough to not want to have to repeat something if you've put out there. I will probably read after stream if that's okay with you. I am very on-off on whether I even read things on Twitter, so forgive me if I'm not up to speed. I guess sending good vibes your way. I don't know if that's an empty gesture, but some good vibes your way right now, for sure. It's not like I can do something. That's fair enough, yeah. At least your body gets the rest, yeah. It is good to have a little bit of that. And perhaps you can wake up your cat from its nap. That's a small payback. No, that's mean. I mean, you do what you want to do. Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course. No problem. Just happy to be here rather than somewhere else. Fair enough. Okay. I'm grateful you're here too, then. I'll make sure of it. Just... take deep breaths. I can't even imagine what happened there. And truth be told, I don't want to imagine it. But it's easy to tell you bottled up. Easy to tell you bottled up everything while you were there. Is it obvious? Kinda. Well, I had to get out of there. It would have only gotten in the way. And besides, I made a promise to come back to... Alright, what's the deal with Stella? Nothing, I'm just... afraid? The word loses meaning after using it so much in so little time. She should have been worried sick, and I couldn't call her after I came back. I'm afraid of what she'll say. She'll insult you. She looks like that kind of girl. But I'm betting all I have that she'll be quickly happy that you're fine and alive.
Yeah, you're right.
Think about it this way. A slap or despair for what's left of her life. A slap or despair for what's left of her life.
I wouldn't pretend to disappear.
Besides, from what you tell me, you're pretty much only coming to your senses today, right?
Yeah.
It's weird how everything can change in such short notice, you know? On Thursday, I was a girl doing her duties, minding only her own business. Now I'm injured and woke up to find out I can't go back to those duties.
Oh, welcome back, Judge Khan.
You. How's the game been treating you?
Adami is happy. I knew full well white knights usually did more harm than good.
Oh.
On the other hand, I really love my job. Now I'm stuck with nothing to do.
Yeah, I know how that is. The life changing on such short notice part, I mean.
Really?
I would tell you why I know that, but I think you should go see Stella right now.
Yeah, you're right.
Speaking of which, hey Jill.
What?
Do me a favor and escort Say to wherever she needs to go, please.
Only if you cover my share of the work.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay then. Let's go, miss.
Right. Thank you for hearing me out, Jill.
Anytime. Too much heavy stuff lately. Jill, yeah. That's very valid. Some days really are too much heavy stuff. But I don't know. Jill seems to carry it pretty well. They're like debriefing at home. Under the warm mattress reading shit posts on the internet. That's a mood. I helped some mushroom men kill some mean slaver dwarves. Perfect. Good shit, good shit. Alright. Let's just put on
Welcome to the Crunch Hours. Here at Parasocial Work Industries, we enjoy crunch.
Spores? Out of 10. Big mouths. Either way, sounds kind of fun. Oh, hey Jamie. Oh, Deus Ex Man, welcome back. Jamie.
Oh, Jill. Jillian isn't here, I see.
You alright? You look distracted.
I'm fine, don't worry.
If you say so. Jill, why do I take 4 if he needs to use the bathroom? The cage has a small litter box included.
Huh?
Oh, that's convenient.
4?
4's my cat. Some apartments in my building are being inspected today. So I brought him to work in case they enter my place while I'm gone.
Oh, I see.
What can I get you?
Usual gut punch.
Coming right up. Time to punch this man right in the guts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. Aged. Next. Yeah.
thought when someone ordered a gut punch you had to make a joke about giving the client a punch to the stomach or something.
All that, in theory, yeah. Jill's the only one who pays attention to that, though.
Really?
He didn't receive proper training. Oh. Huh? He read an old manual my boss had. There was some sort of stipulation mentioning the need to say puns. Seems like it was some sort of anti-counterfeit measure. I mean, if they copied such a silly stipulation, they'd be caught in the act.
Like when the dictionaries added fake words to spot if someone else just copied all of it.
Wait, did that happen? Oh, I've still got toast. Excuse me. Did dictionaries do that? No! Rude! Okay, but like, did dictionaries do that? Did dictionaries ever add fake words for copying?
To stop copying?
What? The Oxford Dictionary added a fake word? To protect the copyright of the publication? Fake entry was included in dictionary.com? That's very funny. What was the word? Tell me the word. Ooh, what word? Esquivalescence. The willful avoidance of one's official responsibilities. That's actually a very fun definition to give it. Esquivalescence. To willfully avoid one's official responsibilities. Wonderful. I am indeed in a state, constantly, of esquivalescence. Ah, I love that. Okay. Yep. Why not tell him that? I read the other day the first dictionary published in Poland had the definition of horse, because everyone knows what a horse is. Yeah. A horse is a horse. Of course. Boomer humor. It's too amusing, to be honest. So, what's on your mind that's distracting you so much? My dad used to make that joke all the time. Nothing you should think about too much. It's like those times just feel uneasy for no good reason. You might have actual reasons to feel that way, though. Come to think of it, mercenary is quite the uncommon occupation, wouldn't you say? I like to see what I do as bounty hunting, actually. How so? The only jobs I don't take are those where I have to deal with people who just happen to be in the wrong place. Mr. Ed followed by Bewitched and I Dream of Genie. Welcome to Boomer Stream. Mm-hmm. We are, Man, I can't even remember free-to-air channel names. Channel 7? I don't know. One of them had all that shit. There are some people willing to pay to off someone that has done no wrong. Things like killing someone that owns a house in the way of some building. A nosy reporter. I'm not better for turning a blind eye to such requests, but I'm not going to be the one dealing with them. The bounty hunter part comes from where? If I'm sent to kill someone that has done something like stealing or killing and I get paid for it, you could see it as bounty hunting. Yeah, I guess. It's just cheap justifications for killing people, though. In the end, they're cheap. However, I won't be one to kill for petty reasons like those. But let's change the subject here. I'll have something better, if you don't mind. Sure. Something better. Bitter and manly? What? Way to gender him. What if he just wants better?
Give him a pile driver. 3. Channel 71 run by Catholics? I feel like it's, what's the family name? Channel 7 is that rich family that is now name escaping me. It's not Murdoch Empire, it's the other ones. All Karma Train, all mixed. Packers! I thought it was the Packers. Yeah, Packer was the family I was thinking of. The Kardashians. I don't think I'm thinking of the Kardashians. However, yes, rich media family. Correct. You have ticked the boxes I put out there. pile driver. Ah, yes. You just reminded me of my grandpa. He used to eat Bronson roots every afternoon.
What?
What's a Bronson root? He said they made him stronger. I'm picturing a parsnip. Bronson roots have more nutrients per gram than most vitamin supplements. Your grandpa knew what he was doing. I never watched TV, so I wouldn't know. It's fine. It was also very niche Australian knowledge. That was an extremely niche Australian reference that we were making. Bronson is one of the ingredients Smart. I see. So, my grandpa was just getting drunk the slow way. Potato looks like Charles. Uh-huh. Yes, I've got no idea who that is. Seems I always manage to make you uncomfortable, Joe. Sorry. Oh no, don't worry. Although I guess it's mostly because I can't wrap my mind around the whole taking a human life thing. Knowing you killed people and are now talking to me here, it's weird. It reminds me of when I first took sex ed class. What the heck? I just realized that the channel changed. Is this just off? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, that's a TV off. It's not a new channel. It's an absence of channels. I am not smart. Couldn't wrap my mind around people doing that stuff and living normally. People having sex and living normally. Absolutely wild. Incomprehensible. Unconceivable. Unlike with sex ed. Better that you stay that way, mind you. Taking lives is not something you should get used to. Ah yes, I know a good way to change the subject a bit. Would you like to hear about the most dangerous bounty hunter in the city? The way you said that was like offering a tail to a bored kid. But yeah, I'd like to hear that one. You see, there was actually a bounty hunter organization in the city not too long ago. I like how there's no signal in Channel 7 there. Perfect. Law enforcement will put a price on a dangerous person's head and pay for the proof of that person's death. There was a guy everyone called Jet Black James. He got the nickname because he always wore black clothes. The interesting thing was that the black clothes were there to hide blood stains he got from his contracts. His tracking skills were top-notch, his information network was the best. Some even joked he would finish the bounty within half an hour, or he wouldn't take the reward. My pizza will be hot, or it's free. He was too good, in fact. At one point, he took all bounties and didn't take a single reward. He was just that crazy by then. The last bounty that the organization had posted was on James's head. The police had him cornered. His last words were, "Send it all to my account," before shooting himself. Eesh. Why hasn't that been made into a movie? So there were no more bounties after that. Yeah, I agree, Poppy, that was really left field. I'm sorry for saying it out loud. A registered bounty hunter was charged with many counts of manslaughter. I hope you're alright with that. Sorry for the... Take a second to chew on some carrot.
Thank you for head pats. I've actually run out of water. I am gonna take this as a sign that I should grab some more water. I will be back in like less than a minute. It'll be 1 sec. I'm glad that it's okay. At least on your end, I'm okay. It was just so fucking left field. I hate it when that happens, you know?
No, I'm so sorry.
Excuse me. I keep forgetting I've got a beer at back screen. Whoa. Okay, we have returned. Oh, I'm all good. Thank you for asking. How are y'all going? I hope you're all right yourself, or like, as all right as it can be, etc. Sippy this water. Coughing. That's just me. My body can be a little bit wacky sometimes, but no, I'm okay. I have water, and it helps for sure. Oh, okay. Registered bounty hunter. Was charged with many counts of manslaughter using his old as proof. I don't remember the context of this sentence. Where did you... No more bounties after that. Okay. Oh. So wait, then they went and charged the bounty hunters? Seems kinda messed up. I was trying to- Oh, I've got toast in my mouth still. God, my beard. Fiji water, not my favorite. Somehow it tastes bad to me. I haven't had Fiji water in a long time. I don't remember it being exceptional, but I'm also not a water expert. Sommelier? Yeah, that. I remember I accidentally bought an alkaline water. Like, I was just trying to grab whatever was cheap kind of thing. And then I started drinking it. I'm like, there is something different. And I, like, actually read the bottle and it's like, oh, this is alkaline. Okay. Same. Just knew that wasn't good. Yeah. I mean, yeah. It's always going to be water, but... I don't know. Water in different places can taste pretty damn different. I'm very lucky to live in a place where tap water is actually pretty good. So... You know, the privileges in life. Say,
We'll click it.
Somebody else tried to recreate the organization. The scene of doubt would grow in little to no time.
Oh, I just remembered. I was trying to remember the phrase that describes when you are targeting an individual over a systemic issue, like where someone is obviously the product of an environmental circumstance, but you are targeting them. And the only phrase that was coming to mind was, don't hate the player, hate the game. It's like, yeah, I guess that. I guess that's kind of what I'm getting at here. I'm sure there's more like fancy ways to say that, but like, don't the these what are they called? Bounty hunters. These bounty hunters are obviously the product of the environment that was financially rewarding them for doing a manslaughter. Anyway, the point. What guarantee is that such an organization wouldn't actually be a trap? They could use the registered bounty hunters to take care of the most bothersome criminals, and then dispose of the bounty hunters by pressing charges using their targets as evidence. So no, Jet Black James made sure that no law enforcement organization is able to set up bounty hunting of any kind. Ever since then, anyone crazy enough to be a bounty hunter works independently. You. It's you. You're talking about you. Were you part of that organization? I've actually had those suspicions I'm telling you about since the day I heard such a thing exists. Glad to know I wasn't just paranoid. I don't know how well you change the subject. That was certainly one interesting story. Oh, I am toast mouth again. Just to make sure, you're not a rebuilt Jetpack James or something, right? The name James is pretty common. Oh, Jamie, right. Besides, if I remember correctly, his real name was actually Theodore. Oh. That story left my throat a bit dry. Get me a beer, please. Chat, give me a beer. That story left my throat a bit dry. I have not had a beer in a really long time. Hey, thank you for the beer. Oh, and water, thank you. Okay, I think I did that right. I'm so sorry that Pop Nemo did not occur. I know exactly what you were trying to convey though. Do I like beer? I'm actually celiac, so I'm like a autoimmune zone points at my body. I have not drunk beer in like since I was a teenager, basically. And then like I found out that I was celiac when I was about 20, huh? 22? Oh no, I'm aging myself. Gasp. Yeah, so I haven't had beer in a long time. I know there's some gluten-free beers, but I like everything that is made gluten-free. That shit don't taste right. The likelihood of coming across something that tastes good is rare. Immersion broken. Pyro is cool, but he used to be much cooler. I mean, that's very true, actually, yes. I take no offense to that. I am so past my prime. I used to be way cooler. The anime boy ages. Terrifying. True terror in my heart. Yeah. Wait, here. One of mankind's oldest friends. Cheers. One obvious thing I see is that you don't take the use of the word kill in your stride the way Jillian does. I'm not good with violence. That's good. It's interesting though. When I compare you two,
It's obvious Jillian has seen quite the share of traumatic stuff. That guy's a handful because of that sometimes. Still, he's one of the most reliable people I've ever met. Where is he, by the way? I asked him to keep an eye on a girl that came here earlier. I feel that if something happened, he could resolve the situation. I'm wondering if it was a bad matchup on my part. Because he's obviously very underground behavior. And she's obviously part of the system. I don't know, I don't think he would... I don't know. Nah, he would have acted weirder. He would have acted weirder if something was sus. His nose must be itching after we talk so much about it.
Yeah, maybe. Well, I've gotta go. Send my regards to your boss and Jillian.
Will do. Man, today's been quite heavy. Kara then pulls up in a Mustang. Kara now, much wiser, pulls up in an economic, fuel-efficient vehicle. Correct and accurate. The, like, poor impulse control para diving in the deep end, and then current para being like, "Whoa, buddy, slow down." I act as if I've matured that much. I've matured mild amounts.
Everyone. Wait. I say it out loud, I feel like I'll just tempt fate. But let's try it anyways. Everyone is just being gloomy face after gloomy face. And that dog. That dog sure had that dog in it. I sure hope the next client changes that. So, wait. You reminded me of someone and now I don't remember who it was. The Persona guy, the punk from Persona 4. What's Sanji? Kanji? Genji? It ended in G, right? You know who I'm talking about? Thank you! I just don't remember his name, but I'm getting that same, like, smoldering bad guy kind of vibe.
So you still work here?
I keep giving all men the same voice. Hashtag not all men. Sorry. So you still work here?
I knew it. I mean... Quite the surprise to see you here again, Mr. Ingram.
Got out of my job, needed a drink badly. I remembered this crack house was nearby.
What can I get you then?
Kanji. Kanji might be it. That sounds right.
We all do have the same voice, TBH.
But no, there are men are diverse. There's punk men, and there's corporate men. And there's... Nope, that's it.
Person who watches too much anime be like... Feminine! Feminine. Wild West men. Hell yeah. Oh, there was the steampunk custodian earlier.
Yeah, there are many, many ways to be masculine, to be genuine for a second. However, right now, I munch carrot. Oh. Okay. What can I get you then?
I'll have a bleeding Jane.
On it. Bleeding Jane. Say the name of this drink 3 times in front of a mirror and you'll look like a fool. I frickin' loved that, urban legend. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Landed.
My personal way is wearing cargo pants and owning several hats. That's a vibe. Hell yeah. Yeah.
Tastes just like the pasta sauce my mom used to make.
Oh, it's a Bloody Mary. I am so dumb. Oh my god. 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 The Bleeding Jane. Say my name 3 times in front of a mirror. It was not until the pasta sauce reference that I fucking... I need a button that makes the screen, come up with a big neon sign that points at me and says, very smart, very intelligent. Oh my god. Thank you for the kindness, sorry. I am bullying myself, aren't I? Yeah, okay. There's boomer men who don't like these kids and their smart chalkboards they carry around. Yeah, and they're really grumpy about me standing on their lawn. Okay. Watered down, artificial and nasty. Damn, just like Mama used to make. So, where do you work, Mr. Ingram?
I don't have a specific job, but there's this, network of engineers in need of assistance. I have no idea what they do there, but I can follow instructions and that's all they need. Recently, I've been working with this Celia girl working on some experimental powered suits. My only duty is to give them maintenance once a day.
Hurry, get off my lawn. I see you put that. Huh? It's comfy. I want to hang out. Why can't I just vibe on the lawn? Come on!
Those nerds know each other and they recommend me. I don't ask questions and quickly learn to do whatever they need.
Sounds nice. You just enjoy getting ordered around.
Pretty monotonous at times though. Why are you giving me that look?
You're just more cheerful than the last time you came.
We all have good days and bad days. Today just happens to be a not bad day. Besides, everyone's scared shitless in their houses. The streets are clear with no traffic jams. That's always a plus.
I guess.
It always became a bad day though, thanks to some teens on the way here.
What'd they do?
It's not what they did, it's what they said. They were talking about how they should just go to Zaibatsu Corp's HQ and
That made you sad.
Seen one too many kids throwing around that let's kill the king attitude when it comes to Zaibatsu crap. Even if Zaibatsu Corp's building suddenly went down, the ones behind it would be still alive.
I see. So it's not an ethical quandary, it's a strategic problem. I see.
Killing the head honcho just means his or her duties go to the next room chopper from the totem. Hell, I bet they're plotting to kill each other anyway. Kids these days see too many action films where the rebels save the day by killing the evil corporation.
Don't let it get to you.
I don't. I just hate teenagers. It's interesting
that a big corporation in control is somehow more dangerous than regular government.
I wouldn't know. I'm not a political person.
No shit.
Alright, give me a Zen Star and try not to mess it up.
Coming right up. Zen Star. I think it's 4 of everything. 1, 2, 3, 4. On the rocks and next. Yeah.
Yep, it's just as nasty as I heard.
Why order it then?
Not your problem. So, where's the red comet?
My boss?
She...
Jill, Paul's headed your way.
Let's play, Four. Let's play! Oh, customer. Sorry for intrusion.
You have a dog here?
And a cat?
Cat's mine. His name's Four. The dog just hangs around here.
He looks well-groomed and his fur looks healthy. Seems you take good care of him.
You seem to know a lot about cats.
No, that's just common sense.
You like cats, Mr. Engel?
I don't dislike them. But I do dislike having animals near me when I'm eating or drinking. So I'll take my leave.
Please come again.
Don't count.
You said that last time. Congratulations, you scared a client off.
Four's as guilty as me.
I don't remember your voice, Rad Shiva.
Four's as guilty as me.
Yeah, but I like Four. It's my baby. Now go play or something.
Right.
Now you're back. What happened with Sane? That cat boomer girl picked up. Couldn't see anything. I guess she was happy. Glad to hear that. Did I miss something? Only Jamie and some other guy came. I see. You look exhausted. Yesterday was filled with people carrying heavy emotional baggage. I don't mind it, but dealing with them tired me out a little bit. I actually found myself wanting Dorothy to burst out that door at any moment. So you miss Dorothy? Ooh. Kinda. But anyway, nothing a good night of sleep can't fix. Let's just wrap things up here and call it a day. Okay. I am making nearly enough money for my frickin' massive bill. My beer stash is running out. Shit, I need more beer. 1,000. Frick. Still got three or four more days to save up for my bills. Monster girlfriend Shirari becomes best-selling video game of all time. The waifu revolution from the 2010s is no longer a laughing matter. Sorry, waifu revolution. Status a trend has gone out of control since the standardization of VR, which allows people to live full-time inside their computers. As a result of this craze, it shouldn't be a huge surprise to know that the popular Monster Girlfriend franchise has become a commercial juggernaut. Millions of copies shipped in Glitch City alone. Worldwide, the game is shipped nearly 90 million. Is the waifu age real? I certainly like fried chicken. During our weekly interview with Prime Minister Quincy, he revealed his unusual taste in a certain rare food, fried chicken. When you taste a chicken breast like the ones that Kenta make, you can't go back. Quincy also confessed his desire to ban instant food, though he said it was in jest. Soccer popularity sinks as pro wrestling rises. After corruption scandals of the last World Cup, fans have begun drifting towards the theatrical magic of the pro wrestling industry. The latest GSF tournament pulled nearly 20 million viewers. The easier-to-follow something we know is predetermined as opposed to something that pretends to be a legit sport. People kicking a ball is boring as shit, too. okay. AM Township 64, this is a new thread. Hype, literally nobody games. Oh, literally no games. Wait, I get this reference. PlayStation. The PlayStation has no games, right? I understand the memes. Is anybody else tied to this Monster Girl meme?
No. I'm gonna marry a Monster Girl.
You just want actual gameplay next time. Why would you want gameplay in a Tsukeban game? All I see is pretty girls with nothing to back it up.
probably going to be another underpowered piece of shit. Remember when games were actually good? Nah. Never heard of it. Games that were actually good? Game doesn't sound like it's doing too well. Gonna buy one, depends on the library. Oh, gonna buy a Township 64, I see. I didn't check what the dialogue was like. The soccer. But I like soccer. Because of that, you're castrated? Wow. Okay. Water time. Wednesday, December 21st. Good evening. Oh, Jill. Good timing. Is it? You two always make me feel like I'm late. If it helps, that dog isn't coming until sometime later. Anyway, you have something planned for Sunday. Watch silly mega Christmas specials with 1,000 grams of black fur on my lap. Oh, a cat. Yeah, right. Why? I was thinking about holding a small mega Christmas party here this Sunday. You in? Sure, why not? Alright. Invite any client you're acquainted with. The more the merrier.
Oh.
You didn't bring your cat to do. The raid stopped. They found whatever or whoever they were looking for. Huh. Anyway, we better start working. Yeah, you better. I'm gonna just leave the music as is. Time to mix drinks and change lives. What channel do I want today? Punching channel. Yeah, that sounds good. Welcome to Valheim. I want a fluffy dream. May I see your ID, please? I don't have an ID because, I'm the ghost of Mega Christmas Past. What? I'll haunt you constantly unless you give me a fluffy dream.
Do you have money to pay for the drinks?
Well, I...
Do you?
Yeah, I have money.
The girl asked for a fluffy dream, but she's gonna be crazy if she thinks she's getting alcohol so easy. So fluffy dream doesn't have to have alcohol? Oh, cool. Then yeah, I'll give you a non-alcoholic one.
There's something sus about a kid that would come into a dive bar like this. It's not that I'm, like, strongly against people drinking before the legal age or something, but this is just sus as hell, you know? She's going to get drunk anyway, yeah, possibly. Possibly. Here you go.
Well, I actually got a drink.
So, you hit a stalk. Miss Ghost of Mega Christmas Past.
Stalk? Oh right, I'm a ghost. That guy, yeah.
Which employee did you leave without a Mega Christmas, Jill? Jill, please. Would it be funny if he reacted to that? Huh? Sorry, kid. I'm not in the mood to humor you today unless you have some sort of ID.
Yeah.
Well, in a year or so, I would gladly serve you a drink. But until then, this is no place for you.
I already got a drink.
A non-alcoholic one. You didn't expect me to really give you a drink, right? So, if you'd please leave.
I can't leave. Not after trying so hard to even get here.
Wait, did you watch the stream? Mega Christmas, my favorite holiday. Sigh. Alright, let's start from the beginning, Miss Norma.
How did you know my name?
I saw your ID.
It could have been a fake ID.
I don't think you're stupid enough to make a fake ID that doesn't put you at least 18. Buy Pride shirt. Ooh, I can vibe with it.
It's very close. Aw, thank you for the kindness. Double deck the halls. I can't read the word mega and not think of the, AJJ song. Okay. More. Okay. You're very sharp, Miss Bartender. You look like a nice girl, Norma. Why come to a bar like this?
You seem like you're in a bad mood, Miss Bartender.
No, she's just like that all the time. Shut up. Sorry if I've been harsh. These last couple of days have been heavy. Having someone underage here reminds me of a certain incident from last week.
Incident?
Well, don't change the subject, young lady. Why'd you come here?
What do you care? I can do whatever I want.
Unless it's illegal, in which case anyone can, should, and probably will stop you.
I just want to be more wild, you know?
Wild?
My mom puts way too many expectations on my shoulders. I've always been out to make sure I don't disappoint her. But it's never enough. It's not good enough to get good grades. She also wants me to go out and take a college prep course. And I'm tired. I don't want to do things for her anymore.
So you came to a bar?
Maybe if I came back home smelling like alcohol, she'd leave me alone. If I'm not good enough for her, might as well kill any hope she has in me.
You remind me of this client I had a while ago. She, passed out in the street and my boss brought her here. Your attitude reminds me of how she got once drunk.
Huh?
Yeah, bitter about the pressure exerted on her. Hers was workplace pressure, but you still remind me a lot of her.
So, what of it?
So before you think of anything else, calm down. I don't want you to go through what she went through.
I'm calm.
So let me get this straight. You came here to make your mother disappointed?
Yeah.
Do you like alcohol?
Actually, I think it's nasty.
Then you're doing things wrong. What? If you're going to disappoint your mom, at least do it with something you like. Like, become a belly dancer because you want to be a belly dancer. Otherwise, you're just trying to hurt her for the sake of hurting her. Let's start with something. What do you like doing?
I don't know.
Such a mood. I actually like this approach. It's like, you shouldn't have to just meet someone else's expectations. But what about your expectations?
I've been so focused on trying to be good enough that I haven't been able to think about what I want to do.
Don't you think you should start there? You want to discipline your parents, at least do it with something you like. Mm-hmm. I like it a lot. What good is doing something just for the sake of hurting someone? She gets disappointed in you over something you like doing. You have the right to protest. But if you're hurting her by hurting yourself over something you don't enjoy...
Sounds silly, huh?
Very. Go home. Do some self-discovery before hurting your mom, would you? Or at the very least, humor her until you're old enough to move out.
Yeah, you're right. Thanks, Miss Bartender.
Call me Jill.
Jill? Alright. Oh, thank you for the meds reminder. Yeah, if anyone hasn't taken their meds and might need to take them. Good prompt.
Careful out there. In the end, you did humor her for a bit.
Shut up.
Oh, a doggy.
Hello, little girl. The voice that I almost did for that was going to be particularly troubling, but that was pretty bad. Oh, took it this morning. 5 days in. Wait. Which... Have you disclosed to us what this is? I don't want to, like, accidentally say the wrong thing. No pressure, of course. Never a pressure. Yeah. 5 days streak, let's go. That is a very good thing to take. Thing to take? Thing to observe. Where is sitting up? I hope that it is treating you well. I don't remember what voice I was giving this dog either. No visible effect yet. Fair enough. It sounds like it's early days. Best wishes with it. Maybe I'll fall asleep. I'm feeling too weak. No worries, opossum. Get some rest. I hope you, wake feeling more rested and less jelly-like. And I hope the waking is your choice and not your cat. At least I hope I wasn't mixing people up there. I'm pretty sure that was a possum that said that. I'm sorry, it is the end of a long week. My brain is a little bit fried. Forgive me if I'm mixing things up. Oh shit. G&J, how you going? You're late. Miss me, Jay? You're too early. Ah, good to see you here. Boss, will you be any good around here? I'm right here. I know. Class. I spent lots of time training him. Why do you think he didn't show up last week? Because how the hell would I know you'd bring a part-time adult? Yeah, let me show you. Sit.
Sir, yes, sir.
Roll.
Sir, yes, sir. Ha. Sir, yes, sir.
Training. Of course. He's only shouting, sir, yes, sir, and not doing anything else. I never said I did a perfect job. Is that a motorcycle?
Oh, shit.
Hey, not in my office. In the end, he's just a dog, I guess. Hello? Akira? Yes? Oh, sorry, it's only for clients. Oh. Promise me you'll buy something afterwards. It's that door over there.
Who the hell are you? The other one.
Ish.
So get out of my desk.
But the world's ending. It's just a motorcycle.
They're the four riders then.
There's a horseman, and it already stopped. Thanks. Don't mention it. I need to buy something now, right? Oh no, you don't have to. Sorry if it looked like I meant to inconvenience you. No, I'll order something. I need a rest anyway. What can I get you? A piano one would be nice. Sorry, didn't hear you.
I'll have a Mars Blast.
Eh, sure. Wait, no, I want to give you a piano, woman. It seemed like you wanted it, right? Okay, sweet, promo happy. What is Mars Blast? It's
Spicy, manly, strong.
No.
You get a piano, woman, my friend. Live your best life.
2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 Papa Delta. 3 Planet Guy. 3 Cometry. Aged. Mixed. Here.
You look happy.
Shut up.
That motorcycle out there yours, mister?
Call me Mario.
Yeah, it's mine.
Sorry for the noise.
Oh, don't worry. It's not like you stayed outside too long or anything. So what do you work as, Mario?
I live to paint the roads black with my wheels, leaving the trail of my engine sounds wherever I go.
It's a very long game, it seems.
Yeah.
It does seem it, hey. I also take a long time with games. I'm so sorry. I don't know how many days will be left.
I'm a rebel. Fuck the red lights. Fuck the speed limits. Fuck helmet laws. The roads are mine and mine only.
Guys, I'm going outside with the dog. We'll advertise the bar.
Hello, doggy. Hello, shady guy.
Shady. I'll be back before long. Don't worry.
Alright. Careful.
Who is she?
Oh, she's my boss.
She is cute. Not that you're not cute, and it's not like I'm into girls either. Not that there's anything wrong with that, I just...
So where do you work, Mario?
I told you, I'm a rebel, eh?
Rebels can't maintain those bikes for too long. What's your day job?
I'm a delivery boy.
Wait, they're goggles! Oh, I thought that was a big 01 on the arm. They're goggles. That's really appropriate, I guess. What do you deliver?
I'm from a courier company, so it's kind of like mail, I guess. I'm always around the city, and I know, like, the palm of my hand. Sure, I might not remember every building, but I remember every intersection and every street.
That's nice. I still can't take detours without feeling totally lost. Did they do anything? The goggles?
Try guiding yourself with the help of landmarks.
Around here, the Saber Station's antenna is a good reference.
I mean, what do I care? Fix that yourself,
bitch. You want anything else, Mario?
I guess a moonblast would be nice.
Moonblast?
Gut punch.
No, I'll give you a moonblast. It's okay, my dude. Sweet girly and happy. You can be a cool biker dude who enjoys girly drinks. Like, hell yeah. Goals. In rocks and glamour. Like, why the hell not? Yeah.
It's good.
It's a moonblast.
Never mind.
Say, Mario, why do you try so hard to keep up that tough guy image?
It isn't working.
Maybe when you arrived and had to go to the bathroom, but after that you just looked cute.
Cute?
So, why do it?
Bikers are supposed to be scary, right? Rebels that cause trouble and ride free from society's ties.
We applied that brand of logic here. To be wearing 1/3 of my clothes and lighting drinks on fire. Which also sounds like a good time.
Guess.
You can do whatever you want and dress however you want. Just that you look like you're trying so hard. Like you don't really enjoy that.
It's not a lie.
Who says you can't dress as a biker and still be a nice kid?
Yeah, but other bikers.
That sounded like something someone in high school would say.
Oh.
I
It's just advice. Don't take it too personally. Mandatory skimpiness is air. Agree. Yeah. Agree. Should not be considered the uniform by any stretch. No, you're right. I don't have to be that way. Unless you want to. I ain't stopping you that. Yeah, but I don't. It's tiring and I don't feel good. I think I'm, I'm about to have my first summer post-top surgery. So, the chilling out shirtless potential is a new phenomena to me. So you'll forgive me as I have some degree of euphoria around that. I appreciate that that's a little bit different to someone being expected to not wear much on the job. That's a very different scenario. So hopefully that made sense. Yeah, thank you. I agree. It is very poggers. And thank you for rocking. Yeah, exactly. It's a cool time. Hell yeah. Okay. If you want, you could try to stay quiet. You're pretty intimidating when you did that. Let's see. We have another drink, or did you have too many already? I can handle another one. Give me a fringe wave. Sure. A fringe wave. Thank you, Para. It sounds very liberating. Hell yeah. I'm a little bit hype. Definitely liberating is the right word for it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the one. Thanks. Say, that guy over there. Jill, what's up with him? Are you dating him? No. Is he seeing anyone? Not as far as I know. You think he... No, never mind, I said nothing. Thanks for everything. Please come again. Ah, Jill, you heartbreaking fuckboy. Blessed. Yeah, what? Nothing. I'll be taking my break now, Joe. Okay, careful. Day 9! Half of me wants to Google how many days there are to this game, but it's also kind of fun not really knowing what I've got in store for me. Billy didn't smell like poo today. That's a new one. Who is Billy? Oh, Billy is the Deus Ex guy. We're finally far enough into the game for me to begin remembering people's names. Let's do this. Must be over soon. You bully. Okay. I haven't even, had any celery. Oh, shit. I haven't had dinner. It's 9 o'clock. That's okay. We will have a couple more carrot sticks. I will have a very late dinner tonight. It is Friday, though. All right, back to business. Back. Any luck? I managed to get out some flyers. Most people are distracted by the dog. I had to tell them to go to the Rad Sheba bar to get their attention. Oh. Anyway, I'm back to my office.
You stay here.
Fine.
The door opens and the crowd goes wild when they see... Ah! Dog!
Sup, little girl? What are you doing in the bar?
Honey, some help here.
Hey, dog, I heard cats in the alley.
Really? I'll check them out.
Well, you really are bad with dogs, huh?
Did I make it too obvious?
Why, though?
I don't know. Oh, hey, John.
Hey.
I think it's because I just got that trait at random. When AIs are created, they're given fears or tastes completely at random. I just happened to get stuck with the fear of dogs and chinchillas. Wait, what's a chinchilla? Oh, it's a little guy. Little gal, little pal. Oh, you're not that little. That is like a giant mouse. What? That's so wild. Okay. I've never really looked at a chinchilla before. See, it's educational. This stream is so educational. If you come with no prior knowledge whatsoever. Chinchillas are extinct? Oh, in-game. Right, cyberpunk dystopia. Sad. Thank God. What will you have? Well, it's that time of the month, so I'll have a Bleeding Jane.
Okay.
Coming right up. In honor of her time of the month. But is it actually? Maybe there's a maintenance cycle. All blended. Yeah. That time of the month. Did Lila menstruate?
Yeah, oil.
No, silly, we don't.
There are a few maintenance things we have to do every month. Yeah.
And what time of the month is it?
The time when I feel like drinking a Bleeding Jane. Hell yeah.
So, how's business?
You'd be surprised by how many people get struck by holiday depression and need some Dorothy in their lives.
It's me. I would love some Dorothy in my life. But like, when we're not doing business. We're like, I don't know. What would I do with Dorothy? We would go watch a shitty movie together and then, like, enjoy milkshakes afterwards talking about how shitty it was. I feel like Dorothy would be a good, like, just talking shit friend, you know?
Although it's also the season with the most competition.
Didn't know you had competition.
Of course I do, both humans and Lilin. Both of them got a sexy Santa dress, and that's not fair. They were sold out, I wanted one too. Well, maybe it's better that way.
How so?
The other girls like to dress in skimpy clothes and show lots of skin. It scares off lots of people.
Huh? Okay.
Eh, fair enough. I learned that the best way to maintain regulars is to just dress normally.
Really?
If I dress normally, I can just pretend I'm some acquaintance. No need to hide me until reaching the room. Hell, some even invite me to a dinner or movie before anything else. Although I must say it's a bit hard to get the clients in... the first place. They can't tell what I do at a glance. And the first time they see me after a call, they think I'm just making a prank or something.
I never saw it that way.
Which reminds me, you serve only humans or you serve Lilin too?
Humans only, but I do have an at least 40% organic policy.
40%?
Human from the neck up. Dicks preferably organic, but I can make exceptions. Females, I'm not so strict though.
Dorothy, that was a pretty weird statement.
Why? You know someone that might be interested?
No, just mere curiosity.
Well, your curiosity left me thirsty. Give me a blue fairy. Big one.
Alright. Big blue fairy.
Even in a cyberpunk future, I don't imagine that every person would, necessary. Ooh, I almost put the wrong ingredient in. One, two, three, four. Armatrine? Sure. Have two. Aged and mixed. She likes what she likes. Oh, I almost overmixed it. Bit blunt, but oh well. I mean, yeah. There you go.
I wonder if anyone has seen fairies after a couple of these.
Some guy tested that by drinking as many as he could. He thought he saw one, but he was dizzy and what he'd seen was his puke.
Oh.
You know, earlier today there was a mega Christmas spirit around here.
What about it?
Then I'm realizing I made a fuss about serving drinks to someone underage. But here I am.
I see. Right.
Nothing in particular. Just a funny story.
I have a funny story myself. The Mega Santa prank.
Oh no, Dorothy's a prankster.
What?
Ha, it's a prank I pull every year. First, I pick a mall, wait for a day with lots of people. Then I go to Santa's lap. When he asks what I want, I say in the most innocent tone I can muster,
I want you to make me a woman.
Sometimes they try to cover it up.
The Lilim wants to be human.
It's then when I say,
after that I say, well, at the very least.
Sometimes I spice it up. Instead of cucumbers, I ask for a... I once thought about screaming, nope. Yeah, I'll consider it.
Although I did get a client that way. I became a regular soon after.
Huh.
Yeah, 3 years and they still don't get that it's always me.
Oh yeah, how old are you?
Old enough, right?
Numbers. I need numbers.
Are you really asking a girl her age that way? Okay then, tell me your age first.
27.
No fair, you didn't get fidgety or anything. Fine, I'll tell you. My model's designed to look between 10 to 13, but my last checkup said my mental age was 24.
How long since you've been deployed?
That's a secret I'll keep with me.
Fair enough.
I expected you to get all uncomfortable talking about your age though. Why didn't you?
With how dangerous everything's been lately, every year you get matters. Getting old isn't a curse, it's an achievement. Damn, Jill.
You should make a shirt with that. Because if you don't, I will.
She's an older person in a young person's body. She is a robot. She is, entirely a robot, as far as I'm aware. An AI that's been, that has sentience and... Lilim is what they're called in this game. And yeah, the, her character is indeed a, sex worker that has chosen a very young body. Which is deeply troubling, and part of her dialogue tree is talking about that. The
Getting enough money to survive and to compete in the marketplace has meant that she needed to stick with a youthful model, even though she's aged much more since then, you know? Which, I thought was a, you know, her character being very self-aware and talking about, you know, the economic necessity or whatnot. Deeply troubling, yeah, but like, that's the cyberpunk dystopia. This is the cyberpunk dystopia. Feel free to do so. It says more about the society than her. Yeah, it does. And I think that that's what makes her character sympathetic, is that, like, it's very clearly someone, an AI, trying to manage the situation. However, it's obviously gut-wrenchingly horrible. Yeah. You want anything else? Let's see. Oh, cobalt velvet. It's been a while since I tried one of those. Alright. Cobalt velvet. Like champagne served on a cup that had a bit of cola left. Okay, I remember this description now. To Avalheit. Yeah. Planaguide. I've come a train. On the rocks. And mixed. We truly do live in a society. Sorry, Repulsive. The first time I passed your message, my brain immediately went, society. Cobalt velvet. Yep, that's the one. You like it? I don't dislike it. Whoa! That music shift. Guess I'm not mature enough for these drinks. Going Joker mode this late in the stream. Hey, honey, what day's today? Friday! Wednesday? Liar! No, the number! 21. Shouldn't you know that? I'm a lil', not a calendar. Thought you would know that much. Next you're gonna tell me to make some convoluted calculation. You can't? I could if I put my mind to it, but it's not something I have quick access to. Yes, I have an inner calendar and a calculator. Those are used in lots of other operations every second. I could do all that, but it's a lot quicker to just ask you. I see. Why do you need the date though? I have something to do on the 26th. Whoa! Hello? The fuck was that? Been avoiding it for a while now. What was that, right? Thank you. Someone saw. Okay, for those who missed it, because I know that, like, you know, you might be tuning out in audio-wise. There's a television that was turned off in the background that suddenly glitched on with a, like, pink woman? Like, pixel. I mean, everything here is pixel. Just kind of glitching on the screen for a bit there. So that's something. That's definitely something. Oh, don't worry. It's nothing dangerous or anything like that. Just heavy. Would you like some help? They look trapped inside the TV. That's a really good point. They did. They looked like they were looking out of the TV and maybe had, like, hands on the TV or hands up or something like that. I may be inserting. My brain may be making up things here, but they looked concerning. Would you like to help me? If you tell me what it is you need help with. Maybe later. I have to go now. See you later. Bye. You think she really can't access calendars and calculators that easily? I guess it's kind of like how even if a text processor can access the computer's calendar, you don't use it for that. Why didn't you tell her you missed her yesterday? Forgot about it.
find any cats.
Why not look again?
Good idea.
Hello?
Whoa, what is this haircut? Damn. What is this haircut? Huh? Another kid?
Maybe the bar got popular at some middle school.
That'd be a hassle.
Good gods, maybe Alma was right. Right about what?
Well, the other day I was asking her opinion on the whole Alice Rabbit thing. Before the whole massive transmission hack thing. And at some point she talked about hacking becoming a fad and said, imagine if suddenly a group of tweens broke into this bar and started asking for drinks. She did say that. Oh, you went back to clip it and you probably seen it, but it was a pink woman. Thank you! I haven't seen the clip. Sorry, my brain just went very fuzzy. No, I will see it later for sure. I think I'm okay. I think it's been a long stream. I think this day will be wrapping up soon, so I'm not too worried. I'm trying to remember where I find my clips. Professional streamer moment. Ayo? Yeah, Ayo. Gonna... How do I turn down the audio for a second? Just so I can rewatch. I wanna see.
I have something to do on the 26th.
Whoa! Yeah! Yeah, okay. Yeah! The like person did have their arms up. I wasn't imagining that. Intriguing.
Whoa.
Intriguing. Thanks for the clip. Hmm, out of 10. Okay. But no, I'm okay. Returning to this scene. I do remember the conversation like this. Today there have been two kids already. Is this person talking? Why are we talking about them without talking to them? Yeah. How would bartending become a fad? Maybe a cartoon? Kids' cartoons don't show any alcohol. True. They seem to be talking. Excuse me. This is no place for kids, so you should... Jill, she's staring too much. She's saying nothing. She's not ordering anything. She's not causing trouble and there's nothing inappropriate here. I mean, nothing inappropriate aside from alcohol. But alcohol's everywhere anyway. What do you suggest? Let her be? Maybe she's just curious about the bar. She's saying nothing. Maybe she's curious and shy. Also, it's rude to speak about people you have in front of you like they can't hear you. Yeah, this is what I was thinking. Come on, she can hear you. They can hear you. Jill.
What?
How the hell did I startle you? What do you want? Can you help me out here with a beer? Right. Huh? Jill, haven't I seen that girl before? Huh? Guard a bit, please. Oh yeah, before I forget. The disposal unit comes on Sunday. You have any expired ingredients on your side? Alright, yeah. There's a bottle of carmatrine that's like a month past. Put it by the sink so I remember to dispose of it. Thanks.
Hey, miss. Yeah? Are you happy?
Am I happy? Well, that's quite a weird question. I'm not sad, I guess. I'm not jubilant, but...
No, I mean, are you happy with your life? With your choices?
Is this a marketing ploy? Deep question. I mean, I might have one or two regrets. But I guess it could be worse.
Regrets?
Yeah, I mean, don't we all?
I see.
Hey, Jill.
What?
Again? Aren't you a bit on edge?
Maybe. What do you want?
Didn't you borrow the screwdriver the other day?
I did. Why?
I forgot to take the coins from the arcades in the corner last week. So I needed to take them out.
Oh, let's see.
Yeah. It's not like they see much action these days, and... Anyway. Chump change is still money. Pocket change has saved my ass many times.
What? You throw it in someone's face while escaping?
That only happened once and the old lady started it.
Right. Why does an arcade still use coins at nowadays? Or physical money when you get down to it?
For the reason arcades still exist. Nostalgia.
Maybe. Hey, miss.
Eh? Yeah?
Do you recognize me?
Do I?
Recognize you?
I want to say I do, but...
Sorry. Really? You can't remember your own sister's face?
What? Wait, what? Sister? Sorry, I don't have any sister?
Not even a sister-in-law?
Oh! Wait. Wait! My ex-girlfriend had a little sister. No way, Gabby? Is that really you? God, I'm so sorry you've just grown so much since I last saw you. How long has it been?
3 years.
Right. So you know her? Yeah, she's actually my ex's sister. So how have you been doing?
I actually had to transfer schools. And I managed to skip a grade thanks to admission tests. I'll be out of middle school next year.
You've always been a smart one, so it's no surprise. Have you thought about what you want to study in college? You said you wanted to be a scientist.
I don't know yet. I guess I still have a couple of years to think about that.
Well, don't feel pressured about that. Maybe you'll need a sabbatical year. So, how's Lenore? Who's Lenore? Her sister, she was my girlfriend. So you actually had a relationship with something that's not a cat? Color me surprised.
Hey, don't talk shit about my baby.
So, how's Lenore doing?
She's dead.
I knew it was coming. God damn it, I knew it was coming. I knew it was fucking coming. Yeah, that... tracks. Yeah, oh indeed, honestly. I knew it was coming. That, like, as soon as I realized it was the little sister, I was like, fuck, something's happened to Lenore. I didn't even know Lenore. This game has built me up to miss her, though. Repulsive. Sorry, I don't think I heard right.
My sister is dead, Jill. She died last Saturday. I came all the way to tell you the news.
Come on, Gabby, stop fooling around.
No, you stop fooling around. I mean, wow. My sister was left to suffer a disease alone while you were all merry here, mixing drinks and chatting.
Wait, Lenore was sick? Of what? Since when?
I'm
something I think about sometimes. People I dated are still alive. Yeah, I feel that. I have one ex that I know is not doing well. That I, like, knew was not doing well. Yeah, I feel that. I guess is what I'm trying to say. It's where I've got it easy, yeah? Localized nanomachine rejection. It gave her a heart attack. Hugs. Hugs all around. She started complaining about chest pain not long after you left. Is all the talk about getting your freedom worth it, Jill? Is your right to be married worth the life of my sister? Oh no, sweet. I can understand grief, but... why are you lashing out at me like this? Did I infect her with the disease that killed her? No. It was too much of a coincidence that she started getting worse and worse right after you left. She got visibly sick after your fight. It'd be no surprise if that fight played a role in killing her. But that's just speculation. Can't expect. And all of that because you wanted freedom? What kind of freedom is so enticing that it makes you hurt a nice 3-year-old relationship? Was this freedom so important you cut all contact with us? Was this freedom so good you left everything behind? Was this freedom worth the life of my... Shut up! I didn't kill your sister, for fuck's sake. It's not like I infected her with the nanomachine rejection. Oh, this is the first time I've even heard she was sick. And do you really know what kind of fear drove me to have that argument with your sister? Do you even understand the fear of feeling your youth slip through your fingers? Do you think it was all easy for me? I was scared. I'm still scared. But I needed to grab a hold of my life. The music shift is my fault. But it has nothing to do with your sister. I loved her. Do you think that fight didn't hurt me too? Yeah. I... Make sure that girl gets to wherever she wants to go safely. Meanwhile, Chief. I know. Come on, Jill. Let's take you home. Home, sweet home. Hey, Jill. You wanna grab something to eat? I'm not hungry. Want me to come in? Keep you company? I'm fine. I need to be alone for a bit. Jill, you can tell me what you're feeling. It's okay. It's not okay. It's not. Come here. Come here. It's just, I feel like part of me is crumbling right now. My old girlfriend was sick, and I didn't know anything about it. Her sister came to deliver the news, and she held nothing but animosity for me. Not only that, I lashed out at her too. History fucking repeats itself. Maybe if I hadn't cowered back then, and apologized, maybe if I wasn't such a selfish little shit, maybe, thanks boss, I need this.
You want me to stay with you today? Thanks, but I actually need some time for myself. Some me time to put my thoughts in order. Yeah, I understand. But don't do anything funny, you hear me? If any weird thoughts come to you, or you feel too anxious, call me. Yeah. A4, she's in your cat, you hear?
I couldn't meow.
Remember to call me. I'll call you later to check on you nonetheless. Jill is feeling down. Really liked that cutesy game poster she saw. Buying it will prevent it from getting too distracted. Jill. Okay, let's catch up on the gossip. Release Makise releasing EKDV 168 update. Isn't that the guns? The guns, right? Okay. I'm feeling pretty dizzy actually. Miki Encore Concert New Act proposes increased 66th American Kid Returns challenges. Let's leave it here. I will read those articles when I play again next week. I don't know how much of this game is left, honestly, but I'm feeling pretty dizzy after that emotional bombshell. And I was already feeling pretty dizzy. I'm gonna have something to eat. Probably important to have dinner. It is very, very late and I still haven't had dinner. Thank you, y'all. Good game. I am enjoying the story. It is taking twists and turns, and they're very good twists and turns. Take care of yourself. Thank you, Poppy. Thanks everyone for being along the journey. You need to talk, DMs are open. Thank you. I think food before anything, you know? kindness and care to all of you as well. Please do take care of yourselves. These are pretty turbulent times in general, so I think a healthy dose of look after yourselves goes to everyone. I will see you again next week. Have a good weekend, if not a restful weekend is good too. Good night.